International soccer returns to Giants Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Number one ranked Argentina is in the face, the number 21 ranked USA. And better than 75,000 fans are expected to brave the sweltering conditions. Argentina is led by 20-year-old sensation Lionel Messi, the youngest player from Argentina to start in a World Cup. The USA is led by Landon Donovan, back from injury in search of his 100th cap with temperatures above 100 degrees at field level. USA Men's Soccer is presented by the United States Marine Corps tonight from noisy Giants Stadium. It is Argentina versus the United States. And a pleasant good evening, everyone. Welcome to Giants Stadium. With John Harkes, I'm JP Della Camera. The big news for the USA, the return of Landon Donovan, back from injury, ready to go.
Well, let's hope that the injury didn't affect him too much, because Landon Donovan is a key performer for the United States. This guy is a difference maker. He's the one with the skill and the speed to adjust and make changes in the game. And, of course, a clutch performer. Unbelievable what he's done at 26 years old.
USA soccer fans can be sitting in on some history tonight as Landon Donovan goes for his 100th cap at age 26 to be the youngest player in a USA men's uniform to do that. And right now, Landon is standing by downstairs with Alan Hopkins.
Thanks, JP. Landon, what does it mean to get your 100th cap, fourth fastest player in men's international soccer history to hit the plateau?
It's cool. I'm proud of it. Good night tonight against the best team in the world, so you can't ask for more than that.
You had to sit and watch England and Spain play against the U.S. What did you learn watching those two games that you can apply here tonight against Argentina?
I think we were a little timid, and we almost had a little bit of an off factor against them. So hopefully tonight we got nothing to lose. Go out, try to win the game.
Congratulations and best of luck to you. Back to you, JP.
Thanks, Alan. For tonight, anyway, it's a no-brainer for the United States to be talking about Landon Donovan, who is back. They're a different team when he plays compared to when he is not on the field. And you can say the same for Argentina's young sensation, Lionel Messi.
Yeah, there's so much to say about this guy. He's one of the best players in the world, exciting player, and all eyes will be on him from his first touch tonight, because his first touch is so good. His instinct in the game is amazing. His speed of play on and off the ball is incredible, and he knows how to take down the defenses. At such a young age, and to accomplish so much in the game, it's amazing. This player, he will be looked after, and it's going to give the defense of the U.S. a hard time tonight.
Obvious comparisons to the legendary Diego Maradona. Argentina's coming off a 4-1 win against Mexico on Wednesday night. Messi scored a goal in that one. For tonight, Messi and Argentina get ready to take on the United States. It's next. Welcome back, everyone, to ESPN Classics coverage of U.S. men's soccer. It is presented by the United States Marine Corps. Giants Stadium capacity is listed now at just over 80,000. They challenge that mark here tonight as the USA gets ready to take on Argentina. Great atmosphere for someone like you that played in this stadium. This has to be huge.
It is huge, and these are the ones that you look forward to, JP, because this inspires you to play in the game. This is why you grit every day in training, because you want to showcase yourself on this field. You want to see what the atmosphere is like, and this is fantastic.
Great pictures coming to you from Giants Stadium in the tunnel. Some very familiar faces there. Let's take a look now, John, at tonight's starting lineups for Argentina and the U.S.
Yeah, there's going to be a few changes tonight. And Gabriel Heinze, you see him back in the lineup. Had a little bit of injury, sat out against Mexico. But, of course, some of the players up top, Aguero, speed, agility, Messi as well up top. But let's talk about Mascherano, the Liverpool center midfielder. Classic, because not only does he break up plays, but his distribution is so good. He likes to look forward early. He finds the players. He's the man to get on top of in the midfield. U.S. midfield there, let's take a look at Timmy Howard, the Everton goalkeeper, has done a great job. But Danny Caleb comes in there. No Carlos Bocanegra this game, but he's out of position there because of personal reasons. But Pablo Mastroianni, Argentinian born, 4 years old, comes to the States. What an emotional night it is for him. And he gets a chance as well to show Bob Bradley what he can do to get back into this U.S. group for qualifying stages.
This was one of the venues for the 1994 World Cup. They had great crowds back then in all stadiums, and this reminds me of that 94 World Cup being in the stadium tonight.
Yeah, absolutely, and we've got the coach from the Argentinians in 94, so what a great atmosphere. And the people are here, they want to see exciting soccer. They're excited about the progress of the U.S. national team as well, and the players that are on display, but also to play the number one in the world is a chance that you can't just give up. You have to come out and see, and this is amazing.
USA coming in as underdogs. They've beaten Argentina, though, twice. You have some good memories of this because you played in one of these games going back to 95.
Yes, I did, and actually I was right behind Lexi. I thought he was going to dummy that, and then Eric Ronaldo with an attacking, brilliant display from him to put that ball in the back. And that 3-0 was that game, and then 1-0 for the U.S. as well. Joe Max Moore getting on the score sheet, and a great finish with his left foot. Casey Keller in goal for both those games. Fantastic that Casey's here tonight as well.
Players out of the tunnel in front of this great crowd.
You go back to those games in 95, Copa America, and 99 as well, and you see that it was unexpected that, you know, the U.S. could have possibly upset them, and what we did is we went out there and we believed in ourselves, and these are great tests. These are the quizzes that go on throughout the week, and the big test is coming up June 15th with the qualifier, but no better team in the world than to go up against number one and see how we can get stronger, how we can get better.
18, Lionel Messi. Everyone will have their eyes on him this evening. We weren't sure if he would start tonight. He did play, started in the game against Mexico Wednesday night, but everyone wants to see him play. We want to see him play too.
Yeah, he's an exciting player to watch. Such great energy in his first touch, confidence on the ball, the way he attacks the defense and runs at the heart of the defense all the time. He just has, like, I want the ball type attitude. You need more players like that. Kind of like a Tab Ramos was for us in that generation. It was an excellent player, Tab, and Messi's like that. He likes to take the one-on-one. That's the risk-taker on the field.
You wonder what these kids are thinking, walking on the field, holding the hand of someone like a Lionel Messi.
Well, a lot of them, hopefully they watch those games and they know exactly the moment that they're in right now.
There's going to be a special presentation made in just a few moments to honor one of your former teammates, Casey Keller. He picked up his 100th cap last year, but they couldn't present him with any kind of symbol for this award because he was still playing overseas and playing with Fulham. Well, what are your recollections of playing with Casey before he comes out?
Just a true professional on and off the field. A great guy as well, but what an excellent goalkeeper. I mean, I think back to so many moments in the games. Like, we were so lucky to have so many great players around us at that time. But Casey goes back to 98 when we beat Brazil. And we were playing in the Gold Cup, and Preki scored the goal. But Casey had the best game I've ever seen from a goalkeeper, especially against a guy like Romario, who was playing up front. And I think Romario must have had probably about 10 shots on goal.
Romario called it, what, the best goalkeeping he had ever played against?
Yeah,
that was so huge. I mean, that made people stand up, read that newspaper again a second time to see, did he mean recently? What did he mean? He was talking about the best he had seen against them.
Exactly. And, you know, you look at the goalkeepers in America that didn't produce, and we've had so many. Brad Friedel, Tony Miola. It goes down the line. Marcus Hanneman, that's overseas. And, you know, Tim Howard as well. But, look, there's so many good goalkeepers, but he's done so well with him. Great accomplishments, Casey Keller.
Still moments away from the anthems and the kickoff from Giant Stadium on an electric night, to say the very least. USA getting ready to take on Argentina. Third of three matches that they were scheduling against as tough a competition, there's Casey, as they could find in advance of World Cup qualifying, which starts next Sunday.
Yeah, and the thing is, as well, you're assessing players. And no better situation to assess players than playing against some of the best in the world. And that gives you a true level of where you're at. And Casey Keller walking up here now. I'm sure a lot of fans in this country, but also Fulham fans, are asking, what's going on with Casey? What's he doing now with his contract as well?
Do you have an inkling at all? I know Seattle has to be interested. He's from that area.
I've been bribed, JP. No comment.
No
comment. Paid off by Casey.
Good.
I can't release it.
This is huge, though, for Casey, who always said he'd like to come back and play in the States, but obviously it depends on the timing. Hopefully the timing is right now.
Yeah, absolutely. And he looks fit. He looks ready to play. And you know when you're out in that field and you're being honored,
when
the players are there, the team, the guys you know, you want to play. That's the first thing, because you love the game so much. There's Sunil Gulati, president of the U.S. Soccer Federation. great honor for Casey.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Casey's out there with many of the players that he played on the same team with as recently as last year, 2007. It's good to see Casey get the reaction here at Giants Stadium.
He joins so many players in the U.S. anyway that have got so many caps as well, represent their country well.
Right now it's time for the national anthems of the two countries on display tonight, Argentina and the United States
of America.
States versus Argentina. Landon Donovan will captain the USA and he will also pick up his 100th cap. So come back with us.